I love it. Ethel's representative met her backstage, said, Ethel, you have an hour before the dinner. Ethel said, well, I'm going back on a show then.
I want to sit here and enjoy it.
So we drag her. Come on, Ethel. Great. You don't want to sit around downstairs for an hour. You'd be singing in the dressing room.
Right, all by myself in the morning.
I want you to meet this young. I don't know if you've ever met her in person before.
I admire her.
Oh, she is dynamite. She's taking a short break from her CBS series, the Stockard Channing Show, but it will be back on the air next season. She's co-starring in the hit Broadway musical, They're Playing Our Song, and she's a delightful young lady. Here's Stockard Channing. Where's your horse? And may I ask what all the hares are doing all over you?
Oh, gosh, I tipped it. I have a furry friend with me today.
Yeah, not a bear.
A bear, yes.
A whole bear?
A bear. It's a little bear. It's a bear.
You wouldn't
I don't
bring
go anywhere
bear
without my bear. No, it's my dog. I got my dog. She goes everywhere with me, so.
Oh, is she back there?
Yes, would you like to meet my dog?
Yeah,
you
want to see?
Oh,
wait a minute, wait.
The brown dog, the bear!
Okay. Look at her. Here we are, hey! No, here she is up here. See, she hears you on speakers all over the place. Here's Mama. Up here. Here we go. Good. Look. What a great dog.
Yeah.
Oh.
Come here.
What is it? Did you fly it in from L.A.?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Very good. But you had to bring her. You've had nothing but disaster in New York. I mean, in L.A., too.
Yes, we finished taping the television show on a Friday.
Yep.
And Saturday, I'm packing my suitcases to go to New York for 3 months, you know, which in itself was very traumatic, since, you know, the rains are coming down, and my husband goes out to get a log for the fire, and he comes running back into the house and saying, the hill is coming down! The hill is coming down! I said, stop that.
No.
And I said, no. I said, make a phone call. How do we know? We're from New York. I don't know about hills coming down. You know what I mean?
Right.
Things like that are acts of God. I mean, in New York, maybe you'll get mugged. Those are acts of man. But in L.A., it's acts of God.
Constantly.
And flood and fire and whatever. So they called, my husband called the people he's supposed to call. And they said, tell us what's happening. And he told them, he said, get out of there. So we grabbed the dog and the cat, and we had to evacuate our house. And the car got washed away. It was totally incredible.
Stockard. And you just bought that house or just moved in, hadn't you?
No, we'd had the house a couple of years, but we'd done a lot of work to it.
That was it.
You know, it's a very strange feeling. I felt
did
like
it stay or did
reel
it go?
You know, it stayed. It was fine. It had some damage to it because the hill sort of slid around and came out right.
You're not on one of those jobs I see in Coldwater Canyon or...
No, not
with
stilts.
On stilts.
All those things are scary. Yeah.
Now, this is fairly, he's wedged in
terrible
against a hill.
Right.
Then I got on a plane the next day, on Sunday. I came into New York. I started rehearsals on Monday. So Monday night, I said, I'm going to take a little breather. I went and met a friend of mine for dinner, and my bag was stolen with all my credit cards, all my money, all identification. I'm carrying a passport around with me now because I have no identification. So, I mean, I said, well, nothing else could happen, you know?
Well, you got such wonderful notices that everything's uphill now, isn't it?
Well, that's all that really matters to an actor anyway, is how the show is doing, I think, you know? It really kind of makes you realize that the rest of the stuff it comes and it goes, but it's the work and...
When you're as famous as you are from television and from films, and you come into a show like They're Playing Our Song, you don't have to audition.
No, I was lucky. I was awful, lousy auditioner. I'm scared to do this. Foul the whole thing up. Horrible auditioner.
Can't audition.
Very bad. Very bad. And so I was very lucky that I got a little toehold because I don't have to do that very much anymore.
What's the best audition you've ever given? If all of them were so lousy.
I don't know. You know, it's funny. I remember the younger you are, I think the easier you are to just go out there and sell. I remember when I was my first real job, I was in Boston, and it was for a man called David Wheeler for the theater company in Boston. And I wanted to do a scene for The Importance of Being Earnest, and I stood up and did both parts. In the tea party scene, and I would talk to myself this way, and I got up and went to the other side, and I went like that, and I thought he thought I was so crazy that he gave me the job because I really didn't know what an audition was. And so I just I memorized the whole scene and did it for him, and it was pretty good. It was pretty funny because it was very unself-conscious.
Did you ever audition for movies?
Oh, yes. The best story about that is for The Fortune, because... it was the first big part I ever had. I had like 2 days here, you know, it was cut out and stuff like that, and like 3 movies. And anyway, so I was in Los Angeles, and my agent said, there's this script that with Warren Beatty and Jack Nicholson, and Mike Nichols is going to direct it, and it's this wonderful part, and you know, you'd be terrific, and he's going to start auditioning people and reading people. So I went in and I met Mike Nichols, and he was very nice, and I was a little tongue-tied, and he said, listen, tomorrow morning, which was a Saturday, Warren and Jack are coming over, and they're going to read through the script, and they'd like someone to play the girl to hear how it sounds for the writer. Would you like to do it? I said, sure, well, can I read the script? He said, no, it's like a cold reading. So the next day I got up, and I happened to be staying in the same hotel the writer was staying in, and I got in the elevator. I mean, there was a phone call, so we're ready for you now. And I thought I was going to be executed, you know? And I got downstairs, and I walked into this room, and I sat down, and there's Mike Nichols, which in itself was enough, because I'd never met a famous person before in my life. And he was very gracious, and the door opens, and in comes Jack Nicholson, wearing dark glasses and a mink-lined Levi jacket. Now, I mean, I'm a girl from New York, you know what I mean? And I'm sitting there looking like I'm from Kelly Girl, first of all, because that's the way I used to dress. Right. Little plaid skirt, you know, going, hello, Mr. Nicholson, how are you? You know? And I'm just like this, and he's got the shades on, you know, and it's real Topanga, you know, Balaboo-boo. And then in comes Warren Beatty with black velvet, you know, jeans up to his neck or something, and also dark glasses, and wear this little Eisenhower jacket. And he sits down in the couch next to me, and I practically fell off the couch.
Right.
So, I mean, they're chatting away, and so I excused myself, and I went into the bathroom, and I turned around three times. I didn't have to go to the bathroom. I had to get out of there and make a fresh start. And I came back in.
Good.
I still hadn't opened my mouth, right? So we start reading the script, and there's about 10 minutes, and they're, like, batting it back and forth. They're a little sleepy, you know. And I read the script, and it says, Freddie, which is the name of my character, enters crying hysterically. And they're like just being real laid back and not acting at all. And I said, this is the one chance I've got, right?
Right.
And it's like enter laughing. And like from nowhere, it's like doing a broad jump from a standing position. And I opened my mouth, and I entered crying hysterically. And I thought Warren Beatty was going to jump 10 feet off the couch. Yeah. Just went, Jesus, what is this next to me on the couch?
How big did you do it?
I mean, you know, I remember one phrase. It was like, I can't remember the words. It was like, you know, I will never speak to him again. It was like that big, you know, and he looked like this. And then Jack started... He like picked it up and he started acting a bit. The next thing, it was 4 hours later, and we read through the whole script. I still hadn't opened my mouth. And then Warren said to Jack, you know, Stockard, what's your name? Stockard? Stockard, interesting name. He said, Stockard's pretty good in the part. It's going to be very difficult to hear anybody else in the part. And I said, that's the general idea.
Right.
So he said, where do you come from? I said, the fourth floor. And I got in the elevator, and went back up to the fourth floor.
And got the part.
And 4.5 months later, I got a call for the screen test.
You can't be timid, can you?
No, you bet you can't.
I mean, you have to walk. You never had to audition, did you?
No, I didn't. They heard me singing at the Brooklyn Paramount. That's how I get cast for Girl Crazy.
Right. They probably heard you in Manhattan from
That's right. That's right. And all the windows were sealed tight.
Really?
Yep.
Gee.
Right through the windows. Yep.
That's a horrendous experience. Because... In some ways it's cruel, but in some ways it's a great test of the stamina and the presence of a performer. Because I used to come to every audition on Broadway, and you always had your rhythm tune. What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Yeah, it's almost like being. And then you'd pick for your ballad the song of the day.
Yeah.
Which in my day was Pienza's song in South Pacific. Some enchanted evening. But you come out, you know, and you rehearse these, and you're paying a guy $20, you bring your own piano, but you had to give him maybe $10, because he used to play with one hand. And you give the guy $10, and you'd see an empty theater, except somewhere in the row, you knew there were a lot of heads. And you come out, and they say, what's your name? Merv Griffin. Okay, Merv, sing your opener. What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Have you got a ballad, Merv? Oh, yeah. He sings Some Enchanted Evening. Next! And you go, oh.
Yeah, it's murderous.
But there was one lady on Broadway who got him. And she used to do the world's worst audition, but they couldn't stop it. That's a law of equity that everybody has to be auditioned. She showed up. Well, they were doing a show here called Say Darling. And in the show, there was a scene where the Broadway producer auditioned people. So they said, what an idea. Get her. Sign her for the show. And they went up to her and they said, you have the part. And the lady said, what? They said, you have the part. She said, oh, no, I don't. I never take a part, I only audition. And turned them down. Don't you love it? That's a true story.
Just spent her life auditioning?
I know. She finally got the part and said, I only audition. I love her.
What do they think they were?
Yeah, we'll come back. Stockard Channing, Ethel Merman. In introducing Stockard Channing, I told you that she's appearing in one of the big hit musicals right now on Broadway called They're Playing Our Song by Marvin Hamlisch and Carol Bear Sager. The show is almost autobiographical in a sense, almost the story of...
Yes, it's written by Neil Simon and about them.
Right, their love affair, and
yes,
then they wrote the words
and
the
downs, yes, then they split up.
Yeah, now they're not going together, but the show is still open, which is really interesting.
Yeah.
It's at the Imperial Theater. Do we need a setup? What's happened around this song you're going to do for us?
This song takes place when Vernon and Sonia have split up because Vernon says that he can't take it any longer, in effect, which has happened to all of us, I suppose. And she's in the recording studio, and she has to sing the song that they have written together, and it's called I Still Believe in Love. And it's a little ironic that she's singing it after she's just split up with him. He has walked out on her, in effect.
Right. Stockard Channing, from They're Playing Our Song.
After all the tears I've cried, you'd think I would give up on love, get off this line, but maybe I might get it right this time. I was there as passion turned to pain, sunshine turned to rainy days, yet here I am ready to begin.
Channing from a big hit Broadway show. We'll come back.